So back here with Robert Nemeth, Councillor Robert Nemeth, Wishford Councillor, Brighton Hove City Council. Churchill Road car park, Churchill Square car park, I should say, even. There's been a few developments of that, hasn't there? Because it's closing at 8 o'clock. I did hear this from someone else thinking about it.
And, well, I thought it was a prank when I first heard it, but it does seem to be real, and several different people have now sent me the message. So essentially, without any notice whatsoever, Churchill Square car park's now closed at 8 p.m. Which I don't think the council's not involved with this, by the way. So the council, it's not the council this time that's, you know, caused this sort of chaos. Yeah. But essentially, closing at that time is going to affect massively the nearby cinema, any restaurant, any
Christmas market pub, coming up at the end of the month.
All
as well.
The Christmas stuff that's forth. It's just the worst possible idea, and I don't know what's behind it. I don't know if there's been some sort of knee-jerk reaction to some awful scandal that's taken place there, you know, involving some sort of public safety issue. So the truth will no doubt come out. But on the face of things, it just seems another mad Brighton idea that makes no sense to normal people.
Yeah, and obviously it's not the council's fault, but yeah, that'd be quite central to church, that car park there. But as you say, because it's kind of at the start of the Christmas market, which is going to open up on the 26th, 27th of November of this month. So it's going to be quite a crucial element to getting people to use that area and look at the market.
I know, and we should be supporting the whole, you know, British movie industry with you know, the new James Bond film. We want as many people as possible going to the cinema to watch these kind of films. And closing that cinema, I mean, loads of cinema customers drive.
Yeah.
Obviously, I mean, late at night, they want to get home safely, so.
Yeah, OK. Moving on to other council elements then. Portland Road, is there an update on that with the pedestrianisation of Portland Road? I think, not pedestrianisation, the kind of the 20 mile per hour limit.
Yeah, so Portland Road, half of Portland Road's in the ward of me and Councillor Gary Peltz have done, and we've been pushing now for several different things. So, as you say, 20 mile an hour is something that we've It was our idea. We've submitted, you know, the right notice of motion to full council. That's ticking along now, and I'm pretty sure, subject to public consultation, that will happen. Lots of tree planting now, again, off our own lobbying, happening along Portland Road, especially in front of the school. The hedge that we had, that we worked closely with the PTA on at the school, is now unveiled, which looks beautiful. Ellie Agnes hedge of about 100 bushes, which helps pollution, you know, aesthetics, biodiversity, all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
We've got seven, you know, decent amount of funding for seven crossing points where we've got all this pavement parking on the corners, which is dangerous and ugly. So that's all these crossing points will make
the
it easier.
Outs.
The build outs, yeah, the corner builds out. Stop people parking on the corners and it allows pedestrians to cross safely. So it's good for motorists as well, because motorists affected by other motorists parking dangerously on the corners. That's already a few good Portland Road things. That's probably enough to say on that.